Hi students, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs for phase 1 of RBI SEBI NABARD exams. So as you all know that NABARD grade B 2021 is approaching, so I would like to highlight this fact that the Spotlight magazine as well as Morning Tales both are important for you. The news that I pick up in the Morning Tales are right from the Spotlight magazine. Why did I discuss this thing? The reason behind this is I am getting many queries on Telegram group that whether should we cover Spotlight magazine or should we cover the Morning Tales only. So my answer here that Morning Tales is just the video explanation of Spotlight magazine only. So you can skip the Spotlight magazine. Spotlight magazine is really important for your exam. So cover it up for 6 months at least. So on that note, let's begin this video for January 29, 2021. But before that, those who are coming for the first time, guys, do subscribe and hit this bell notification. Also, you can join this Telegram group where you can ask your queries directly from us. Okay, so the people who are coming for the first time, guys, subscribe, because in the coming days, we will be providing you with various sessions regarding RBI Grade B 2021. So if you don't want to miss those sessions, then do subscribe this channel and hit the bell notification as well. So here is our first question. Where is India's longest road arc bridge named as Bori Bridge located? So this is India's longest road arc bridge, and it has been recently inaugurated at or in Meghalaya. So guys, who is the CM of Meghalaya? It's Conrad Sangma, and he inaugurated this India's longest road arc bridge. So that's all. It's a very simple question. I don't think any explanation is required here. My question from you is that you have to mention the national parks and the wildlife sanctuaries present in Meghalaya. So if you know the answer, then do mention it in the comment section below. Also guys, since this is the longest road arc bridge, this reminds me of the longest tunnel in India. So if you know the name, then mention it in the comment section, because recently we had discussed it. In the recent months, we had discussed about this tunnel. So tell me the name of the longest tunnel of India. Now our next question is, with which country has India signed an MOU to design, make and launch a pupil satellite? So guys, we have Sri Lanka, Maldives, Bangladesh, USA and UK in the options. And from the five options, the right answer is Bangladesh. So what is the purpose of this MOU? The MOU is basically for designing and launching the pupil satellite. Pupil means student. So the satellites which will be developed by the students, or we can say to encourage students to develop satellites and develop their interest in science and space sciences. This MOU has been signed by both the countries. So it is India and Bangladesh. So that's all for this question. Okay, so as we know that Bangladesh founding father Mujibur Rahman's 100th anniversary is being observed, and on that occasion India is producing, or we can say India is co-producing a film on Mujibur Rahman. So who is directing that film? It's Shyam Benegal. So this is a fact that you have to remember. Next question is, which company has hosted the International Climate Adaptation Summit 2021? So guys, this basically is a summit, and there is nothing I would say that is there to be discussed from this news. It's just a basic summit that was organized by a country from the options. So let's first read out the option and then answer this question. So we have Italy, Denmark, Germany, Philippines and Netherlands. International Climate Adaptation Summit 2021. Which country hosted it? It's Netherlands. So again, as I mentioned that it's a very basic summit, such kind of summits are being organized by various countries to reiterate their goals, their targets that they have set to achieve the targets of Paris Agreement. So this is one such kind of summit that was hosted by Netherlands virtually. Okay, so here this reminds me to ask you the capital and currency along with the Prime Minister of Netherlands. So these are the three questions that you are going to answer me in the comment section. Okay, so the next question, this question is important, guys, and I think that this question can be asked in the examination of RBI-JP, so do listen to me very carefully. Okay, so which company has launched its new app Krishi Sakha to guide farmers or the Krishis in adopting best farming practices and enhancing productivity? So we have Aviva Life Insurance Company, Bharati AXA General Insurance, DHFL Primerica Life Insurance Company, Bajaj Alliance Life Insurance Company, Edelweiss Tokyo Life Insurance Company. Which company has launched this Krishi Sakha? So the right answer is Bharati AXA General Insurance. Now the Krishi Sakha, the name itself is conveying the meaning or the message of this application. So the message or the basic purpose of this application is to provide guidance to farmers so that they can adopt the best farming practices and increase their productivity. One most important feature of this application is that the farmers will get access to the portal of Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. So this is why this question is important, this application is important, and I think a question can come up on this news as well. So do remember this thing, it's Bharati AXA General Insurance, and this application provides access to Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. Now my question from you is, when was this scheme launched? So the year of this scheme, this is a very basic question. I expect my students to answer this question correctly. So do mention your answers in the comment section below. Okay, so we have the next question. Who has been appointed as a board member of the High Level Advisory Board on Economics and Social Affairs from India for a second term? So who has been appointed from India as a board member of this UN's High Level Advisory Board on Economics and Social Affairs? So this, first of all, let me tell you that this high level board has already many people from different countries, from different institutions, and from India. One person has been selected in this board. And who is that person? Let's read out the option first and then find out the answer. So we have V.L. Kantharao, Nidhi Chibba, Vishal Gagan, Jayati Ghosh, and Rakesh Mittal in the options. Which one is the right answer? The right answer is option D, Jayati Ghosh. So she is the person who has been appointed for the second term as a board member of this high level advisory board on economics and social affairs of the United Nations. Since we are talking about United Nations, so you are going to tell me that how many UN specialized agencies are there in the world. So this is your task. If you know the answer, then mention the number as well as the name of UN specialized agencies in the comment section below. This way your static GK will also be prepared through your current affairs video. So do mention your answers of the questions that I asked you in the video. Okay. So on this note, let's end this video. I hope that you have enjoyed a lot and learnt a lot during this video. And if you have, then share this knowledge with your friends as well. Thank you so much for watching this video.